The preservation of the Developmental Biology film series was made possible by generous contributions from Distinguished University Professor of Geosciences, Lynn Margulis, Terrence Malick, Chelsea Green Publishing, The Politics and Practice of Sustainable Living, the Hardy Lane Foundation, the International Symbiosis Society, GeoBook Studio, publisher of The Biggest Picture, Hummingbird Films, producer of the documentary Symbiotic Earth, and supporters of the Lynn Margulis Archive at ScholarWorks.
The behavior of cells is affected by many factors. One of these is the adhesiveness of cells to objects in their environment. The activity of insect blood cells in culture illustrates how cells behave when exposed to different surfaces. Here, a sample of blood is taken from the pupa of a cynthia moth. The blood is placed in a special culture chamber that is later mounted on a glass slide and examined under the microscope. Insects have in their blood a group of cells known as hemacytes. The hemacytes are colorless amoeboid cells that are somewhat similar in function to the white blood cells of vertebrates. In culture, the hemacytes quickly adhere to the glass slide and begin to move on its surface. Their motion here is speeded up by time-lapse photography. The actual elapsed time of this scene is 2 hours. Some of the cells become extremely flat and develop a broad, fan-shaped structure known as a ruffled membrane. Others remain rounded. Notice how individual cells change from one form to the other. Hemacytes exist in many sizes and shapes. Their movement on glass appears to be random, and even though they contact one another, they never cluster or aggregate. On a flat glass surface, they tend to become arranged in a single layer or monolayer, thus maximizing their contact with the glass. If hemacytes are prevented from adhering to a glass substrate, they will adhere to one another. In this experiment, a suspension of cells is pipetted into a flask and set on a rotary shaker. The gentle swirling of the shaker keeps the cells suspended and brings them into random contact with one another. In a few minutes, the cells begin to form clumps. In 15 minutes, all the hemacytes have gathered in multicellular aggregates. What happens to a hemacyte clump when it is allowed to settle on glass? Time-lapse photography shows that the individual cells crawl apart and gradually spread themselves in a single layer over the glass. Although hemacytes will not clump with one another under these conditions of stationary culture, they sometimes form aggregates with cells of a different type. During certain stages of an insect's life, isolated fat body cells are found in its blood. These large, dense cells have no power of locomotion. They remain at rest when cultured alone. But when fat body cells and hemacytes are cultured together, the two cell types clump in heterogeneous aggregates. The hemacytes apparently have a great affinity for the fat body cells. A migrating hemacyte that encounters a fat body cell adheres to it strongly. Some hemacytes become attached to two or more fat body cells at once. Contraction of the hemacytes results in an aggregation of fat body cells. Clumping of fat body cells, then, may result from the fact that hemacytes adhere to them more strongly than to glass. Hemacytes also adhere strongly to certain foreign bodies introduced into the culture. These spheres are beads of synthetic resin. Clumps of hemacytes have attached to the beads and are slowly spreading over their surfaces. In this fresh preparation, hemacytes are partly attached to the glass substrate and partly to the resin beads. The contraction of individual hemacytes pulls the beads across the field. Hemacytes adhere to the beads in greater and greater numbers until no cells remain on the glass. Apparently, the hemacytes have a stronger affinity for the resin than for the glass. The behavior of insect hemacytes seems to vary with the adhesiveness of objects in their surroundings. When they have no other surface to cling to, they adhere to one another. When they are placed on glass, they separate and spread over the surface in a single layer. But they leave the glass and form aggregates when they encounter fat body cells or resin beads. In other words, hemacytes seem weakly adhesive to one another, more adhesive to glass, but most adhesive to fat body cells and resin beads. There are parallels between the behavior of the hemacytes in culture and their behavior in the animal. One of the functions of the hemacytes in the animal is to help heal wounds by forming a cellular membrane on the injured area, just as they do on glass. Another function is to protect the animal against parasites by surrounding and thus isolating foreign bodies, a behavior reminiscent of the coating of resin beads in culture. Finally, the cells may play an active role in morphogenesis. The fat body is a solid organ in the pupa, but breaks up into individual cells during the development of the adult, only to be reconstructed into a solid organ in other more appropriate parts of the moth body. There is some indication that the hemacytes help reaggregate the dispersed fat body cells within the insect. It seems that the behavior of hemacytes is profoundly influenced by the nature of the surfaces they meet in the living animal as well as in culture.
Thank you. Thank you.